Beach schools have long held a reputation for providing unique opportunities for students identified as intellectually gifted. One of the reasons that the gifted program is so successful is that there is a resource teacher in every school. And that includes high schools, where a resource cluster approach is making a difference across the board.
So this is a content investigation.
This Ocean Lakes High School classroom may look like any other, but this is actually an example of clustering, a concept that has been used in elementary and middle schools for well over a decade, but considered new at this level.
The cluster concept is where we take identified gifted students and we kind of group them together with certain teachers.
The thought is that the students become a learning community and teachers will push and challenge them in the classroom. It's also a continuation of what exists at the elementary and middle school levels.
The clustering component of that is really about two things. One is providing time for gifted students with their intellectual peers. There's a direct link to student achievement in all of that, and then giving gifted resource teachers an organizational structure that allows them to support those gifted students on a regular basis. The more we can group students together in a homogeneous fashion among gifted learners, the higher the achievement, and our research results from our evaluation demonstrate that.
A second reason for clustering is purely administrative. A high school may have as many as 500 identified gifted learners and one resource teacher.
It's more realistic that the GRT is going to be able to work with students on a regular basis if they are clustered in certain classes rather than spread out all over the school.
At Ocean Lakes, the cluster model is 9th and 10th grade identified gifted students clustered in their core curriculum classes.
So in 9th grade, identified gifted students will work with a cluster teacher in world history, and English 9 Honors, and Algebra 2 Trig, if they're enrolled in that class, and in biology. In 10th grade, they'll work with the English 10 Honors and chemistry teachers.
A great way to measure growth is with a 9th grader, to watch them as they go through their high school career, and to be able to meet them when they're brand new and watching them carve a niche out for themselves and literally grow, but also to academically grow. It's a wonderful thing to be able to witness.
Let's stop. What's the big idea here? Why are we learning what we're learning?
Gifted resource teachers and other instructors practice differentiation, where they recognize students and their interests, how they process information, and then take the curriculum and modify the lessons to meet their needs.
The great thing about teachers is part of our evaluation, and we're always trying to think about how do we differentiate instruction. And when we cluster teachers, they have yet another resource person they can go to help them differentiate instruction.
I hear from parents that they want their kids to be in tighter homogeneous groups so that they're challenged by their peers to think more critically and more analytically.
Everyone kind of helps out each other, and so if we have any questions or anything, people are really jumping on you to help you out, I mean. But there's a lot of work, and it's a lot more complicated than normal classes would be.
Whether the student is identified as intellectually gifted or an identified individual of the performing arts, parents should know that the model of the high school level is centered on the child.
At the end of the day, what we're hoping for all gifted students in Virginia Beach is that by the time they leave us as seniors, they've maximized their potential, because the program is really about individual success and maximizing the potential that the child has.
The cluster of gifted students is in the same class with others. Teachers are using gifted strategies and tools to push all. Some schools are clustering at grades 11 and 12 as well.